So that's the beauty of editing videos. You don't know, you only know now that, because I'm about to tell you, I just dropped the phone. So the video, I was like, oh no. But you won't know that happened if I didn't tell you. How good am I to tell you that? So today, we're going to do a video on the 100 most valuable football clubs in the world. I like doing my lists about football or soccer if you're American. And I thought this was a great list to do. I also looked at a couple of other similar articles on this, but they only looked at the top 30. So this way I've got the top 100. And I know it's genuine because it is through transfermarket.com, who know everything about football. They literally list and record everything and anything, from a player's wage or whatever to how many caps some bloke who plays for Congo got during the 1920s. You know what I'm getting at? They have everything on here. So we're going to start with our 100 most valuable football clubs. But I need to get to it first, because at the minute we're on 1 to 20, I think. I want to go from 100 to number 1. There's no point starting at number 1. That's no fun. Who wants to know who is the 100th richest club in the world? I don't. Not necessary. First, that's not what I'm going to get excited about anyway. I hope everyone's good. I hope you've had a great week. And I hope you're going to enjoy this video, guys. So, let's get busy. In at number 100. Wow. 100. Hello. We have La Liga club, Getafe. They are worth 72.3 million. They're 100. Okay. In at 99. We have SC Braga of the Portuguese League. They're worth 76.9. We have Genoa CFC of Serie A, who are worth 77.2. We have La Liga club Levante. UD. I don't know what the UD stands for. If someone could tell me, please do. They're worth 77.4 million. We have Club Atletico Independiente of the Argentinian Primera Division, worth 77.5 million. From the exotic sounding Club Atletico Independiente to Middlesbrough. Middlesbrough FC of the Championship at 95. They're worth 77.58 million. We have in at number 94, Girona of La Liga, who are worth 77.6 million. Wow, Girona are worth more than Middlesbrough. That's shocking. In at number 93, we have AS Saint-Étienne of La Liga, of Liga 1, who are worth 77.8 million. Number 92, La Liga club Leganés, who have 78 million. In at number 91, we have SC Freiburg of the Bundesliga, who have 79.3 million. In at number 90, Turkish club Fenerbahce, who are worth 81.1 million. In at number 89, we have Guangzhou Evergrande Taipao. I thought they were worth a lot more than that. Of Chinese Super League, they're worth 81.5 million. In at 88, German club FC Köln. They're in Bundesliga 2. They're worth 81.7 million. Over in the Turkish league. For some reason I thought Besiktas were Portuguese. I've got that wrong. Nope, it's definitely Turkey. So, in at number 8-7, we have Besiktas of the Turkish League for 82 points. Six, we have Club Bruges of the Jupiler Pro League, that's the Belgian first division, 83.5 million. Number 85, Cardiff City, who are in the Premier League obviously, and are worth 84.6 million. Number 84, and another Turkish club, a very famous club, Galatasaray, who are worth 86.3 million. Back to the Bundesliga First Division. We have Hannover 96, who have 89.4 million. In 82, and the Russian League, we have CSKA Moscow, who have 91.3 million. Number 81, and over to Holland, Feyenoord Rotterdam. So Feyenoord, 12 of us. Worth 91.9 million. In at number 80, we have Shakhtar Donetsk from the Ukrainian League. They're worth 92.7 million. We then have in at number 79, RCD Espanyol Barcelona from the La Liga, who are worth 93 million. Back to Russia, in at 78 we have Spartak Moscow, or Moscow, however you say, 95.7 million. In at 77 we have FSV Mainz 05 from the Bundesliga, who have 97.2 million. And in the Championship we have West Bromwich Albion, West Bromwich District and Building Society from the Championship, 97.3 million. Now we get on to number 75 in Liga 1. It is FC Nantes at 97.9 million. 74, Aston Villa of the Championship, who have 98.7 million. 73, and back to Russia, and Lokomotiv Moscow from the Russian Premier League for 99.3 million. We now get into our 100 million clubs. And then at 72 is Cagliari Calcio of Serie A for 101.2 million. And at 71 is Red Bull Salzburg of the Bundesliga for 101.3 million. Also in the Bundesliga, we have in at number 70 FC Augsburg for 101.7 million. At 69, we have Udinese Calcio of Serie A for 103.8 million. They've actually dropped a couple of places by the looks of it since this was last done. In at number 68, Club Atletico Boca Juniors of the Argentinian League, 104.6 million. Boca Juniors brought through some great players over the years. I'm sure they're responsible for Ortega. I'm pretty sure there was. Ferron. And a hell of a lot more besides. Probably Crespo as well and a few others. I'd love to see who they've brought through over the years. I'll have to have a look at that. In at number 67, another very exotic sounding name, Huddersfield Town of the Premier League for 108.5 million. In at 66, FC Girondins Bordeaux of Ligue 1 at 108.6 million. At 65, we get another two French teams coming up. At 65, Stade Rennes FC, so Rennes of Ligue 1 for 112.2 million. And 64 is LOSC Lille of Ligue 1. Ligue 1 with 115.7 million. In at 63 we have US Sassuolo of Serie A for 119.2 million. 62 SV Werder Bremen of Bundesliga for 120.5 million. At 61 we have OGC Nice of Liga 1, 127.2 million. Then back to the exotics, number 60 we have Stoke City of the Championship, 133.8 million. I think what this does show, I've said in the past, I did a video saying how the Championship is the second best league in the, well, it's equal to a lot of the top teams around Europe. And why shouldn't it be? If you look at that, Stoke, Villa, West Brom, Middlesbrough, all in the top 100 clubs in the world. I mean, Stoke have more money than Werder Bremen, than Udinese, for Christ's sake. Udinese had Cavani playing from a while back. You know, it's ridiculous, really. Number 59, Zenit St. Petersburg, who have 137 million. They are obviously in the Russian league. 58, VfL Wolfsburg of Bundesliga, 140.6 million. 57, Torino FC of Serie A, 143 million. 56 is Sporting CP, Sporting Lisbon of Portugal. Obviously, Ronaldo started out there. Well, he was there when United signed him anyway. He might have started out at a smaller club before going to Sporting. They are worth 144 million. Number 55, Atalanta BC of Serie A, 147 million. 54 is UC Sampdoria of Serie A, 148.6 million. 53, VfB Stuttgart of Bundesliga, 148.7 million. 52 is Eintracht Frankfurt of the Bundesliga, 149.8 million. And number 51 is Watford FC of the Premier League, 150.9 million. Top 50 now, guys. In at 50 is PSV Eindhoven of the Eredivisie, that's the Dutch league, worth 152.2 million. Number 49, Newcastle United of the Premier League, 156.6 million. I'm sure the fans would love to see Ashley put his hand in his pocket this window coming up. 48, Hertha Berlin of the Bundesliga, 156.6 million. 47, Brighton and Hove Albion of the Premier League, 159.3 million. 46, Burnley, wow, Burnley, well, they are in the Premier League, so I guess that makes sense, of the Premier League, 163.8 million. Sorry, 0.5 million. 45, Real Betis Balompi of La Liga, 171 million. Number 44, Celta de Vigo of La Liga, 171.5 million. Number 43, AFC Bournemouth in the Premier League, 173. Number 42, Villarreal CF of La Liga, 176.4 million. Number 41, Athletic Bilbao of La Liga, 187 million. And another Spanish team, number 40, Real Sociedad of La Liga, are worth 193.5 million. Number 39, and my local club, Wolverhampton Wanderers of the Premier League, are worth 196.2 million. Number 38, Crystal Palace of the Premier League, 197.3 million. And in at 37, Borussia Mönchengladbach of the Bundesliga, 212 million. Bit of a jump up from Palace there. 36, we have 35 is TSG 1899 Hoffenheim. What does TSG stand for, anybody? Do you know? I don't. Of the Bundesliga, 221.8 million. 34 is Fulham FC of the Premier League, 225.4 million. In at 33 is Sevilla FC of La Liga, 230.4 million. In at 32, it's a bit of a joke, Southampton FC of the Premier League, 239.4 million. In at number 31, FC Schalke 04 of the Bundesliga, 240.2 million. Number 30, FC Porto of the Portuguese League, 240.6 million. In at 29, Olympique Marseille of Ligue 1, the club that Joey Barton used to play for and Chris Waddle, currently Dimitri Payet. They are worth 245 million. Number 28, SL Benfica of the Portuguese League, 251.5 million. Number 27, West Ham United of the Premier League, worth 258.7 million. And at 26, we have AS Monaco of Liga 1, who are worth 266.3 million. I think it's fair to say that Henry is not having the desired effect of Monaco right now. It's not going very well for him, is it? So the top 25 clubs in the world. Wow. Top 25 richest clubs in the whole world. In at number 25, guys, we have Ajax Amsterdam. Yeah, baby. Ajax of the Eredivisie, worth 271.3 million. And now the money start jumping up. In at number 24, RB Leipzig of Bundesliga, 297 million. And now we're getting to the 300 millions. Number 23, SS Lazio. What's SS stand for? It's not to do with the Nazis, is it? Like the SS? Surely not. Of Serie A, 303.9 million. Number 22, Leicester City of the Premier League, 310 million. Number 21, Olympique Lyon of Ligue 1, 336 million. And now we're into the top 20. Oh, it's exciting now, isn't it, guys? AS Roma of Serie A, 343.8 million. Number 19, Bayer 04 Leverkusen, Bundesliga, 363.7 million. 18, and Valencia CF of La Liga for 379.8 million. Number 17, Everton FC of the Premier League, 383.4 million. Could have said that a couple of years ago until those new owners came in. Number 16, Borussia Dortmund of Bundesliga, 425 million. So a bit of a jump up on Everton. We've gone from 383 to 425 million. In at number 15, AC Milan of Serie A, 437.4 million. 14, SSC Napoli of Serie A, 463.9 million, another big jump up there. And an even bigger one now, I think, or equally as big. Number 13, Inter Milan of Serie A, 499.5 million. We're now to the 500s. Number 12, and that is Arsenal FC of the Premier League, who were 516.6 million. Now listen to this jump up from Arsenal at 516 to number 11, Juventus FC of Serie A, 705.1 million, just under 200 million more than Arsenal. And now we have your top 10, guys. Top 10 clubs in the world, richest clubs in the world. Number 10, Bayern Munich of Bundesliga, 727 million. They've actually dropped a couple of places recently. Number 9, Manchester United of the Premier League, 751.5 million. I think that comes due to a lot of the debt that they have. Number 8, Hotspur, who will run very, very well with the Premier League. 753.7 million. They've risen a couple of places. Number 7, PSG, Paris Saint-Germain. That's crazy. You think of the players they're signing. Mbappe, Neymar, Cavani, the money they're spending. They have 780.8 million. Number 6, Chelsea FC of the Premier League, 803 million. Top 5, guys. Top 5 richest clubs in the world, or most valuable clubs in the world. In at number 5, Atletico Madrid of La Liga, 808.2 million. You don't think of Atletico having a lot of money because it's rare that they don't really spend buy like £100 million players or anything like that. I guess that's why they have so much because they're so well run. Number 4, Liverpool FC of the Premier League at 821.7 million. In at number 3, Real Madrid of La Liga at 923.4 million. Any guess who the top 2 is going to be, guys? If you've been listening carefully, you'll know. You'll have a good idea who's missing from this list so far. Any guess? My club's bitterest rivals at the minute. Does that give you a hint? And Real Madrid's biggest rivals. Does that help you? Yeah, of course. In at number 2, we have Manchester City of the Premier League. 982.3 million. But even bigger than that is number 1, FC Barcelona of La Liga, who are the only club on this list to be valued at more than 1 billion. Wow! 1.1 billion. Well, it says 1.11, but I know it's like 1.1, then like 1. I don't even know what the hell it is, but it's 1.1 billion. Anyway, that is ridiculous. That's a lot of money, guys. Hope you enjoyed that list. That's your top 100, your 100 most valuable teams in the world. The whole world. I know there's no Scottish teams there. Maybe that says something about the Scottish League in general. I reckon you'd probably find a conference team there before you find a Scottish team there. No offence to Scottish people or Scottish football fans. So, moving off of that for a moment. If you check my channel out regular, you'll know that last week, or earlier on this week, was it? What day was it? Yeah, it was this week then. I uploaded a video, a non-ASMR video, of something I recorded on a trip to Birmingham city centre to do some Christmas shopping. And the video was of a busker stroke beatboxer. It's fantastic. If you haven't seen it, check it out on here. It's non-ASMR, it's really good. Yeah, so it's non-ASMR, but it is really good. And I came back yesterday from doing some more bloody Christmas shopping. It's all I seem to do this time of year. Let's go shopping. Hope for some fun. Now for presents for people. Oh, bloody hell. And I had a message on YouTube, a comment on that video, from people who run Birmingham TV, it's a channel. Can we put your video up on our channel on TV? It's like, yeah, of course you can. Okay, great. We'll give you a credit. Wow, how good is that? So, I'm going to my video, which is actually an ASMR video, which is good, is going to be on TV. But then again, I don't want people to see these videos on TV. So, that. In other news, rather sad news, something I found out last night. So, I don't get a lot of ASMR people following me. Like, next to none, really. People who watch ASMR, yes. Actual content creators, not really. That's fine, I don't mind. But there is a creator, content creator, ASMR wise on here that I've watched on numerous occasions. Not too regular, but enough to know who she is. I'll give her a bit of a shout out. If any of you want to go and check her videos out, she's really, really popular in the ASMR community. And her channel is called Sassy Snacks. If you want me to spell that out, I'll put it on in the description or something. And she has a couple of channels, one for like an eating ASMR channel and one for like crafts. Yeah, she's like, she makes things ASMR style. And my wife has watched her a few times, and she checked out one of her videos yesterday or something or other, and found out that she's very unwell. She has stage 5 pancreatic cancer, I think I was told. And unfortunately, she hasn't got long to live, from what I've been told, and that's a real shame. And I just want to send out our best wishes from me, and I'm sure from all of you as well, watching this today. And yeah, if her content isn't your cup of tea, just go check out her channel and just drop her a comment saying, you know, good luck. I don't know what you're actually saying in that situation. I don't know. Just send her your best wishes, basically. It's a real shame for anyone ever to get that, or any sort of illness or cancer or whatever. And being a fellow ASMR content creator, I want to give a bit of a shout out and let you all know that while we're all enjoying our Christmases this year, well, most of us will be, some people aren't that lucky and won't be enjoying theirs, unfortunately. So let's just take a minute throughout your day or this evening or whatever, just to think about the people who have a bit of a shitty life. Anyway, football, wow. Let's get back into the football theme of things. This weekend we have football coming up, obviously. Premier League is back, baby. Yeah, hell yeah. Going off that again, quick time. If you follow my wrestling videos on here, check out my wrestling content on my wrestling podcast channel. You'll get the link in the description below. If you don't like wrestling, it's not for you. But if you do, check it out. Come support the channel. And it's going very well at the minute. I'll say that. It's getting there. Right. So, football. Let's take a look at the fixtures this weekend. Also, check out your fantasy football team if you're part of our league. Make sure you make your changes. Do it now. Do it today. Don't wait till tomorrow. It'll be too late then. You don't want to get to tomorrow and miss out on points like I always seem to do, because you'd always remember to make substitutions. Whether a player's injured or, you know, suspended or whatever, get them out of there. So tomorrow we kick off. Well, there's no early kickoffs. I hate that. You need an early kickoff every Saturday. Makes your Saturday what it is. Brighton and Hove Albion against Leicester. Can Leicester finally sort of settle down after their tragedy that happened with their owner and get a result at Brighton? I don't see it. I think Brighton win this game. I thought Leicester would beat Burnley in the last game, but they didn't. I think Brighton win this one. What score, though? What score will it be? I'm going with Brighton win this 2-0. We have Everton Cardiff. Sorry, guys. My eyes are a bit achy. Everton v Cardiff. I am going to go with an Everton victory there. 3-0. Cardiff, I don't see him getting a victory away at Everton. And Everton, I think, must have too much with Richarlison and Walcott and Cenk Tosun and Calvert-Lewin and Sigurdsson if he's fit. Fulham v Southampton. I'm going with a Fulham win here. Southampton, terrible. And I hope Hughes gets the sack, because he just annoys the crap out of me. He's such a bad manager in the Premier League. He still gets his jobs, so that's what annoys me so much. Fulham to win, 3-1. Man United, Crystal Palace at Old Trafford. We can't lose another game, surely, or drop points again. United victory, 4-0. I think we'll romp home in this game. Watford, Liverpool at Vicarage Road. It is Vicarage Road, isn't it? I thought for a second that I doubt, so I've got that wrong. Watford, Liverpool. I'm going to go with Watford to win this one. 2-1, I think. I hope that happens. West Ham, Man City. On paper. I mean, it's Pellegrini against his old team, Man City. On paper, he's saying Man City every day of the week. But I have a funny feeling about West Ham in this game. Then again, if I now do, it has to be fit for that to happen. And who else is the other lad? Oh, bloody hell. Ukrainian lad, ain't he? Just because of a bad injury, he's going to be out for a long time. That's a big blow. What the hell's his name? I know his name. It's on the tip of my tongue. signed from Dortmund, who's doing really well. Just drop in the comments because my mind has gone completely blank. I need some sleep. Let me know of his name and I said that was it. I knew it all along. I want West Ham to win if Arnautovic is fit. If not, see you to batter him. 5:30 kickoff tomorrow. I'll be watching this game. Tottenham taking on Chelsea. AC Milan, that's pretty big. 5:00 on Sunday in Italy. France. Nope. Holland. No. So, there's only a couple of big games on this weekend. They've got Tottenham against Chelsea. Lazio, AC, Atletico against Barcelona. So, if you want three matches to watch, they would be my three matches if they're all on TV. Obviously, Tottenham, Chelsea is. I'm guessing Lazio, AC, BT Sport, and you know Barca away. Atletico will be on TV as well. So if you watch three games, watch them three matches. Bye. Hello. Hello, Barn. Right, guys. So this video was full of cock-ups. The camera fell over. Sky Sports notifications went off twice. And to top it all off, the last like 3 minutes of the video, I know, but in mic volume. I'm a bit sick of that happening, actually. So, thank you for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Comment below. Thumbs up. And I'll be doing a football agent roleplay on Sunday. And football review Monday and whatever else during the rest of the week. Thank you for watching.